empty, pointing every finger at me, waiting like a stalking butler, who upon the finger at murder now the battle must wait, just because the sun is coming. Jesus wants to try and wrestle.
Okay, today I am presenting a problem that tempts not my faith, not my belief, but the overall. No wait, that isn't exactly accurate either. As this cannot truly be seen as blasphemous, nor heretical or upset or tarnish the name of God nor Jesus, nor does it lead my faith in any direction. But I can't help but feel the ominous presence of myself looming over this. Like Mexico is doing to the US. Waiting like a vulture for them to fall so they can scavenge them for whatever resources they can for their own country, along with Japan and North Korea, who are waiting for China's fall to do the same, or what Germany is waiting to occur to Russia so they too can all do the same. One thing I should add pertains to a claim I made that mentioned I had assured humanity's survival for the next 1,000 years. Specifically, what I was speaking about was this. You all have seen the trail of evidence to my ability to project across time to influence events of the past, as well as being capable of reaching out to those far into the future who have tried to establish communication with its source, that I have presented solid proof to lately on my channel. Having faith in that, know that I have already appeared and projected to every moment over the next 1,000 years, and with a calculated nudge, which was all that was needed to objects such as these, I have diverted and redirected every single asteroid that will ever come into a collision trajectory with Earth in that time frame. That was what I meant by that. My premonition was going haywire over this subject, so I thought I would add that for whatever the situation that may currently be arising against me might be squelched before it even begins. You see the, again, which leads me towards a topic I am curious of, and its conclusion may be more simple than you think, so follow this concept to its end. What if Jesus was the concept for a messianic figure that was a plan designed by an ancient group of sorcerers in the later half of the Egyptian dynastic period, whose purpose was to be that of a hidden old world super soldier type character made from perfected and protected bloodline of intentionally bred and selected to comprise someone, say, both highly in tune with the mystical resonance or mana pools and thus able to sway the elemental aspects of the earth, but also augmented with an enhanced genetic design, sort of a Solarian and Osirian hybrid and Unarchy, macabre superman able to regain out of control.
Something I should add here is a sense of order to Hell's armies considering its current lack of decorum. So the regiments I will lay down as this, if you wish for your involvement with my efforts to be known and rewarded or recognized, this is how we'll break it down. If you are an avatar of someone within one of the orders, then you must leave some calling card, a sigil or symbol that represents your magic and yourself. The arcane orders have this already in place within one of the Akashic archives within the many different realms. But for those who are unaware or not advanced enough to be appointed one, then you should start. Hell's ranks will be broken down to divisions based on the sins of your conviction and damnation, the one that heaven holds over you more so than any other. These sins usually come with some skill or technique, as most sins are reactions and survival instincts gone out of control. We'll divide those skills into infantry wave divisions, strongest effect of intentional methods on the front line, weakest effect in the middle and moderate effect in the rear, old Spartan formation. We'll divide the ones whose sins they knew nothing about having been caused and intentionally designed by both heaven and man as the front line commanders or lieutenant, keeping the infantry divisions in formation and issuing commands passed down by the chain of command. Those who knew of these orchestrated events and fought against those who manipulated their lives but that fact was overlooked when the axe came down will be the main infantry division that surround and protect the generals and demon lords. Generals will be divided into a hierarchical formation: those condemned, those who are the tormentors, those who govern over the tormentors, the angelic ranks who were assigned to a position over the infernal realms. Then the noble class would be the children and bloodline of the fallen and rebel angels, with the nine fallen ones as the dukes of hell's flame, as they are the matriarchs of our bloodline, and as six rebel angels at the inner court and barons of hell. Above them will be the angels of sin who were assigned to the aspects of evil through their principalities. These are not official army formation positions unless it is that necessary, as this can be used as a solid surface-to-surface combat template unless you're dealing with numbers of soldiers exceeding 3,000. When dealing in numbers that high, you should take what projectile units you have and space them out between infantry and grenadier, allowing the inexperienced to be shielded by the experienced from falling at the beginning of any battle, but also assisting the army as a part of it and not an obstacle by supplying the grenadier with whatever ammunition they use. You can set them all in one long wall of soldiers, or you can separate them into rectangular divisions if you suspect them of trying to flank your forces from the sides and encircle you. This system is mainly to put in place a means of communication and recognition for deeds done, and reward if any will be available for them, so don't get your hopes up. Remember, this is hell, so assholes should be expected. You would be surprised at how many former kingdoms have used this method to hide emergency contingency plans for war within family tree or tapestry that depicts the hierarchy of a king's court, just as I did here. This could be a useful tool for civilians who might find themselves in need of a military force but have only common citizens to choose from, in hiding these tools in plain sight without anyone stumbling upon it, unless it's pointed out. So for hell, a common damned spirit who, for whatever reason, gain an opportunity to take some last minute actions before completely crossing over, if discovered and grilled by priests in an exorcism, or you are given a chance and see a path before you to return and seize your chance, then you would say as you leave something like, I am called Vince Clotho, a demon of the eighth plane of sin, which is the realm of blasphemers and governed over by the damned one, Balthazar, and ruled over by Borachiel, the angel of evil manifest. I serve a line of unholy nobles who are begat by the angel Azazel, who is appointed as the angel of the night in the creation of the heavens and lord of darkness during his fall into dominions with the rebel angels, and then the harbinger of desolation, to whom all sin was attributed, to when he was cast down for rising against heaven, the one whom heaven calls, he who is the shepherd of lost souls. Any who question the validity of this, tell them it was decreed and set into place by Lucifer, who is the keeper of the infernal realms of perdition, as was his appointed dominion when he fell into his dominion long ago.
The galaxy would have fallen if Revan had not gone to war. Perhaps he became the Dark Lord out of necessity to prevent a greater evil. Revan's choices were always his own. It was not teaching or circumstance or example, it was him. And there is something that the Council may never understand, that perhaps Revan never found.